That's pretty handy. It just hit the call button on the last call, and it calls everybody.
Yeah.
Is Disco?
That's me.
Oh, that's cool. Okay, Chico, we can hang up on him. He's retired.
He's the vigilante of this.
What do you guys think about me recording this one, putting it up as a podcast again?
I'm good with that.
That's cool.
Just pay my fee.
Pay your fee. Magnum, are you going to sign the release form?
I don't know, man. My arm's broken. I can't really sign
it. It's just like signing a car insurance form. It's the same thing.
Sure, whatever's good. It doesn't matter.
Oh, God.
You said Chico retired?
Chico didn't really is retired. Let me just do like a quick 10-second intro to this. Everybody, welcome to, what are we calling this? Three-way dance? We've got five guys. Or is it four? We've got four guys.
Well, Chico's retired, so it's three guys then.
I don't know. We'll just... I was actually thinking of doing like a weekly segment called and just throwing it on the Armchairs channel. Call it Armchair Bookers.
Not bad.
Armchair Bookers, it works.
Yeah.
All right, I'll just do a quick intro. Welcome everybody to the initial episode of Armchair Bookers. I am Dirk the Work Burton, aka Michael Mercy. I am joined by a couple of other great workers. Big heel Scott McCulloch. How you doing, Scotty?
That's Danny Blanchard to you, Burton.
Danny Blanchard is his working name. We've also got Jack Pisco Disco. His nickname is Pisco.
Yep.
Yep. And rounding out this all-star team is Magnum G.R.
What's going on?
Also known as George Rappos. So we're watching Raw right now. We're about how far into it?
15 minutes.
Seems like an hour.
Stone Cold would say it's too damn long.
It's too damn long. God damn it. We're a little different than most wrestling. I changed the fucking channel on my TV, and I don't know how to get my show back. I'm watching snow, so you guys just talk about the show while I take about a half hour to figure out how to get back on the show.
The rapper snow, right?
Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing here. Oh, I see. Okay. Basically, our style for covering wrestling is we don't really cover it most of the time because most of the time it's boring, and we just entertain ourselves with some other shit going on. We're easy breezy, much like armchair directors, the way Matt and I talk about movies. Same way we talk about wrestling, we're here to have fun, and if it's not fun, we make it fun. And I'm playing fetch with my dog. Tell me if that's annoying, and I'll stop.
I think we've made some of the worst Raws in history, some of the most entertaining Raws in history by talking about stuff that has nothing to do with it.
I agree. I guess if people want to sync this up, my... I'm at 8:17 right now. I don't know. We kind of come in when we feel like it. We leave when we get sleepy. It's just usually 9:30.
And some of us don't leave and still sleep.
Can you guys hear this dog growling?
Nope.
Okay, good. What'd you guys think of TLC?
Gimmick heavy.
It was okay. It got kind of monotonous after a while. It's like, okay, I've seen the 1,000th chair shot, but that's to be expected in a TLC pay-per-view, right?
Yeah.
The matches that were supposed to be terrible were pretty bad, and the matches that were supposed to be decent were decent. Like, I don't think anyone expected it to live up to the NXT pay-per-view thing,
yeah,
but
the
matches I thought were going to be good were good, and you know, the matches that didn't need to be on the card, like Ryback and Kane, were just terrible.
I disagree with that. I think actually they thought because of all the gimmicks, they probably thought the show was going to be way better. It's just, I think it was just too much, just too damn much. Like someone said, like too many people went through tables, too many chair shots. You know, by the end of it, when you get to the main event, it's like basically a combination of all the matches you've watched up to so far, and no matter how good Bray Wyatt or Dean Ambrose is, are, they just felt very, it just felt like, well, another fucking chair, another fucking ladder, another fucking thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I think it's cool that Ambrose main evented his second pay-per-view in like 3 months. But and that spot where he lost, where the TV blew up in his face, was amazing. But in like afterwards, it's like that made no sense at all. Why would a TV explode?
Have you ever pulled a TV from the power cords?
The TV doesn't explode. Like, there might be a spark where the plug is.
I don't know if you ever tried running warp speed while you're holding the TV with connected to wires, right?
Well, hold on. If you remember, he tried to hit him first, but for some reason, I guess they had like mag lock on those cords.
Snagged.
They just like they wouldn't break, and then all of a sudden he gives a one good yank, and it explodes in his face.
You know, somewhere the Shockmaster was watching that, going, ha 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 ha, Sting, ha 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 ha.
You know what would have been funny? If he like ran full speed holding the TV, and then like as soon as the TV would like just wouldn't budge, he just, instead of like him like dropping the TV, he just kept holding on and he just fell on his ass.
And waiting. If he Geritroned himself.
If you pull power cords like that, you're right. It probably doesn't work that way, and TVs don't explode that way, but
I think Batista needs to run in right now and ask for a last douchebag standing match against Jericho.
But before that, he's got to stand on the ramp for like 5 minutes pointing at himself. Put the spotlight on me! That was my favorite when he was in the douche-tista gimmick.
Oh, man.
So I noticed earlier they were calling him, and they're making a point of it like they do whenever they come up with something new that they think is the bee's knees and the cat's ass. The Vigilante Sting. That's his name now. The Vigilante Sting. Do you really need to give a guy who's been around for, what is it, 25, 30 years a new nickname? What's wrong with The Man Called?
Maybe they don't own that. They don't own
They don't own The Man Called, but they had The Man Called Vader, or that was the man they call Vader.
No, GR has a point. They don't own the music to Sting's old music, apparently. It's owned by TK2K Sports or whatever the fuck.
Oh, so he's the Vigilante Sting.
Plus, it makes it more mysterious, you know, like the Batman.
I don't like Sting. I don't like it. What do you guys think?
No, I don't really like it. He didn't really. What did he do that was so, like, vigilante? The same thing that Triple H and Seth Rollins were doing, but he just did it.
Yeah, it was a run-in. He didn't even have his bat.
He didn't need a bat. He's Sting. He's the Vigilante. He's like Batman. He doesn't. He can kick your butt without going to his gimmicks and his utility belt.
It's hilarious that we're just talking over top of this Jericho promo. It's his big return, and I couldn't give a shit less.
He just made a match with him and Paul Heyman.
So is Jericho the GM for tonight or the GM?
Yeah, no, not tonight.
Okay.
Yeah, he's taking a break after this one.
Like Corny, Jim Cornette says, one fuck shall not be given. Jericho's back. Who cares? He's got a scarf. Scarf is Jericho.
He was here in Toronto last night.
Yeah, this isn't the main event. This is Woodbridge was the main event.
Yeah. Live podcast or something.
I do like how he was trying to get his $200 back from Heyman from the Best of Jericho ECW VHS tape. A lot of those ECW guys, they don't forget, eh? Like, they don't forget. You got Balls Mahoney. You owe me $750, Paul. They all know exactly how much they're owed. I'm sure the franchise character is hunting for his couple thousand. There was. Do you guys listen to MLW radio?
Yeah. Waiting is awesome. Boom.
MLW. Disco was on one of the recent ones, and he was saying how whenever Shane Douglas talks about himself, he always says the franchise character. I don't think that's what the franchise character would do. It's just hilarious to me because he seems to think he's in like the top five echelon of greatest wrestlers ever.
funny, you're talking about greatest wrestlers ever. They were airing that on the network, that 50 greatest superstars.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that list was pathetic.
You know what? 17 came up. I was enjoying it for the most part. Hogan being kind of high in the number was kind of strange to me, but it's politics. True story. Number 17, I saw Ric Flair's picture and turned it off. It was like reflex. I couldn't even help it. I was like, 17, Ric Flair, fuck this show.
When I was watching, I was like, Bruno was 25 and then Hogan was 24. And I was like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah. Let me guess. John Cena, top five.
I think it was like, it's like Cena, Rock, Undertaker.
Michaels, number one, probably.
Michaels and Austin were in there. No, Cena wasn't top. I think Brett was top five at number five.
I thought Brett was four out of ten.
Four, maybe? I missed four. Well, they had like Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio was like top 10, and I was like, what the hell?
Any top 50 without the Dynamite Kid on it is not a legitimate top 50. Just ask Bret Hart.
What about the trips, though?
Yeah, we've got some in-jokes people aren't going to get. Okay, just
hold on, I got one.
The quick explanation of the Bret Dynamite connection. Have you guys noticed, I'm talking to the fans, have you noticed that most of the time when Bret Hart speaks lately, he talks about the Dynamite Kid, and it can be something completely different, like not related to even wrestling. They could be talking to Bret about the Calgary Hitmen hockey team, and inevitably, Dynamite Kid gets brought up, Stampede, and 1984, the year 1984. It's always Dynamite Kid, Dynamite Kid, Dynamite was a good hockey player. We're watching a promo right now here in Canada. Watching.
Is he coming to Kitchener?
I miss those old regional promos they used to cut.
What they do now.
How awesome is that? You know, like you'd have Jake Roberts with the python going, "Let me tell you something there, my man. When we come down there to Frog Stomp, Arkansas, I'm going to show you what it's like to be cold-blooded, my man."
I'll tell you, Hawk, it's going to be exciting when we come to the 7-Eleven in London, Ontario.
Not even London, man. It'd be like,
I know.
Smallest, you know? Paris, Ontario. Tell him, Hawk. Well.
He finds out it's Paris, Ontario, and he's pissed off. He actually thinks it's Paris, France.
What a Paris, yes.
We're coming to Paris.
Vince, we flew to Paris. There's no one here. I'm going to get drunk. So I missed the Ascension promo, apparently, was on SmackDown. They ripped off the Legion of Doom.
Oh, it's a really...
It's an aggressive homage.
Yeah.
Tell me about it.
Welcome to the Wasteland.
So are they painting their faces now?
I don't know, but... No, they didn't really look painted. Speaking of painted, man, that friggin' Finn Balor.
Oh my God, greatest entrance ever. Period.
I've never seen him as Prince Devitt. Did he do that before?
Yes,
he did. If you see pictures of him in previous matches, he has that.
It's unfortunate that there's no way of being able to tell what Prince Devitt has done in the past, other than like tape trading. Oh, wait a second. There's YouTube.
I got a question.
Shoot.
I thought we were talking about Finn Balor. Who's Prince Devitt?
I don't know. Some guy.
I don't know.
I heard he has a beard. I don't know.
Yeah, he's...
Is he feuded with Prince Iaukea or no?
Is he black?
Prince Iaukea.
He's a Blanchard, isn't he?
He's the black Blanchard.
Yeah. That entrance, like with everybody, blew me away. And I showed my wife. I was like, "Hun, you got to see this." And she's not really a wrestling fan. She tolerates it. But even her, she was like, "Wow." Like the theatrics, the light... choreography, and I'm glad that that's going to be a sometimes thing instead of an every week thing, at least on NXT. I could totally see Vince calling him up in 2 weeks going, "God damn it, where's your paint, kid?" And doing it every week. That's got to be a Muda type of thing where he busts it out just rarely.
Yeah.
He did make Hideo look very, very boring. Minuscule.
Apparently, he did have a tag team partner in that match.
I totally forgot.
It was a tag team match against. It wasn't a one. It wasn't a one on two against the Ascension. No.
I just can't. Like the name Finn Balor, I think is cool. I can't get used to Hideo Itami. It is such a tongue twisting, weird name. You can't chant it. You can't remember it. It's like. Okay, he didn't have to keep Kenta, but why did he come up with Hideo Itami?
What? Why did they promote that they're signing Kenta, and then now they use a totally different name? Like,
that's
I don't
a
think
good
they
point.
Promoted as Prince Devitt. I don't think they did.
No, they didn't. They didn't. They never promote any. It's the first time, as far as I can remember, that they promoted anybody and then changed his name the moment he stepped into the ring.
God, that was just stupid.
Yeah, didn't they interview him and they called him Kenta?
I think they did.
Yeah, they did.
And then he said his new name is Hideo, whatever.
Yeah, and then they had like a big interview segment to explain why he changed his name to Hideo.
Yeah,
the
Hideo
other name
was Hideo Nomo, was it not?
Was it really?
Tommy was Shinjiro Otani.
You know, apparently they tried to do a Kenta chant at the
you got booed.
Our Revolution. Yeah, they got booed out of the building.
Yeah, the sheeps have bought in. And then immediately after, a Hideo. Hideo, like the most awkward chant.
That is kind of awkward.
Hideo!
Yeah, it doesn't roll off the tongue.
That has a good chant.
So we're in the middle of a Big Show, Luke Harper versus Dolph, and don't tell me this is a...
The Vintner.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, don't tell me this is a handicap match. I've seen enough of those. And the Great Muda, a.k.a. Eric Rowan. Does anyone else think Rowan's theme song sounds like Great Muda?
Still say it should be the Toxic Avenger theme song.
Yeah. Garbage Man. Yeah, those guys killed each other at TLC. Harper and Ziggler. Ziggler's just out of his mind.
I thought Harper broke his arm when the ladder fell on his.
Yeah, that looked
closed on him. It's crazy.
It was ugly. Oogly.
Near the end there, when Ziggler fell, and he looked like he nailed his neck on the top rope. It looked pretty bad.
He's got bruises all over his body. Both of them do.
AJ's injured too, you know. She got real hairspray in her eyes. It seems like something like, you know, someone does it just as a joke to screw over Punk. I'm going to really put hairspray, not hit water in that bottle.
AJ really needs to be in a match where the stipulation is if she loses, she has to eat a sandwich.
Yeah, she is pretty damn skinny.
Oh, by the way, yeah, I caught that picture you left in that thread.
The skeleton?
Yeah.
There's a group on Facebook called The Flock. Bunch of great guys there. And
you're addicted to The Flock now. Man.
And somebody was saying, hey, guys, lay off AJ. She has a nice body. So I posted a picture of a skeleton saying, that's got to really turn you on.
I must have missed that one, too.
Flock.
Can't keep up with all, like, 150 pictures per day.
The Flock is like WWE. It is what you make of it.
Yeah.
There are a couple of Marky Marks on there, but you use your block and you never see them again.
Yeah, but it's all about the Funky Bunch that makes it fun.
Yeah, exactly.
You have all the Marky Marks you want, but without the Funky Bunch.
If you see something you don't like, you can just bust out that old Willy Wonka picture.
I love towards the end of the show.
We'll have to come up with a picture that we disapprove. So you see that picture, you know we don't like that pose.
There's got to be a picture out there of Kenta Kobashi saying this post gave Kenta Kobashi cancer. Too soon? That's Disco's gimmick right there. I owe him like $50 for gimmick infringement right there.
I did think towards the end of that show, everyone was posting people sleeping.
That was great. HBK on a bus and the crowd sleeping. There's a guy asleep on the toilet.
Dog sleep in his dog bowl.
All right. That was great. That's what it is for me, man. I can't watch wrestling alone anymore. It's depressing and boring. I mean, NXT was an exception. That thing was off the charts. But for the most part, it's like a group thing. It's Mystery Science Theater, totally.
Yeah. That's the way I feel when I watch Saved by the Bell episodes.
Yeah, we should do live commentary for Saved by the Bell with what's his name? Adrian Neville is on that show, isn't he? Oh wait, no, that's Screech.
I saw that pic. That was crazy. Yeah, I think Screech only got that. They only put the Rocket on Screech like that one episode when.
you're talking like it's a wrestling show, so they booked him strong.
They did, because he
put
like
the Rocket on him
for some reason. Kelly needed to work with him on a homework project, and they like got to the point, oh god, they're pushing this guy for the entire episode, and yeah. next episode he was pushed, he's jobbing Ziggler.
And then he becomes the Santino comedy gimmick, making spaghetti sauce in test tubes or whatever they put it in.
And towards the end, when they came the new era, he was like the general manager.
Yeah. All right.
Managed that show for like 7 years.
I gotta say, there's a match going on right now, and I actually saw something I like. I gotta give props when I see something good. Luke Harper, man, he is awesome. He is so old school. He does the little things, like he steps on an ankle while he's waiting for his partner to come in. He grinds the forearm into the face. Just all these little touches to make it look like real fighting. Because I like my fighting fake. I don't like people actually getting brutalized and obliterated. I saw pictures of some of the aftermath of the UFC fights on the weekend, and these guys are just like mangled and butchered. And I guess, hey, if that's cool, if you like that, that's fine, but I just can't watch that. I'm like, these guys are fucking concussed and aren't going to remember their kids' names you know, when they get old. Not that the wrestlers are going to fare much better, but I don't know, just in some weird way, I'm glad that this shot right here Dolph took across the rope here. And he's acting like he's hurt. I'm glad that he can actually breathe easy tonight instead of like having to ice his neck to breathe.
Oh, a couple years ago, Jerry.
As you say that, Dolph looks up. He looks like hell.
Well, yeah, he looks like one of those UFC fighters. He's doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong, Dolph.
I don't know what that was. But
it's not supposed to really hurt.
I always find it like they never give these guys any time. Like, this guy's had a brutal match last night. Did they really need to be fighting this terrible tag match? Like, give them a night off from the least working. They can do a promo or something, but
the problem is the entire card was involved. The entire roster was involved in that match and matches like that. You know what? In the old days, when the Hardys and Edge and Christian, the Dudley Boys, they were in a match like that, the next night they didn't work. They cut a promo, but they didn't work.
Yeah.
That was respect. I mean, like, you killed each other. At least we should give you the night off to heal.
But
maybe a week off.
That's a good point. But at the same time, Foley was almost murdered by The Undertaker in his cage match. And they sent him back out at the end of the night to do a run-in on Stone Cold's match.
I thought that was more like he was just out of it completely. He didn't know what he was doing.
Like, they picked him up off a stretcher and said, you got to go do a run-in.
Maybe that doctor gave him a Z-pack or something. I don't know. Oh,
probably. That fixes everything.
You're good.
Yeah, but, like, it's ridiculous that these guys, especially Ziggler and Harper, at least they're in a tag match. That's kind of a night off.
why does Big Show need to get this win? Like, give Rowan a chance. Holy crap.
Well, forget Rowan. Give Roman a chance. This didn't make Roman Reigns look strong at all.
He's coming out right now. Wait, you don't know.
Banner.
He's coming to make an impact right now.
If you thought my promo was bad last week, wait until this year. I mean,
believe
2015.
If you thought I threw a lot of guys, he's going to throw 29 damn guys out of the Rumble. You know what? Vince is going to have a conference, a big like group meeting, and Roman's not going to be there. He's going to be getting dressed, and Vince is going to tell the other 29 entrants, make Roman look really, really strong. He's going to throw them all out.
We'll have him come out number 30. No one will be eliminated from the Rumble yet.
I love it.
And they'll just come and
I love
it in 1 minute.
Armchair Bookers in action right now. That's what's happening. Armchair booking.
Yeah, Royal Rumble, I can't wait, man. It's going to be so good.
Okay, so a match happened. Who cares? Somebody won, somebody lost. It doesn't
Luke
matter.
Harper was,
it doesn't matter.
Doing nothing in the match. It was outside brawling, but he's so happy that they won this nothing tag match.
It doesn't matter. Dolph Ziggler, hell-bent on mimicking his hero, Kurt Hennig. He'll probably be dead by the age of 45 also, just because he's insane with his bumps. I mean...
We cut to Michael PSA's girlfriend and Fandango.
Me and Heel, before we came online here on the air, we were... they bleeped Jericho out while he was making fun of Fandango's name. And we were thinking, like, what could he have possibly said? Like, I think one of them might have been fan butthole. But,
yeah, he said fan dunghole, I think.
Dunghole. And then I was like, well, probably fan... I don't even remember. I don't even remember.
So this is your guys' pre-show that we got to miss.
Fan fuckbag.
Fan fuckbag. Can you imagine the shareholders? Oh. What did he say?
Or fan cunt hair.
Fan cunt hair. That's a Stone Cold favorite. I've been listening to Steve too much.
Did you notice them cutting out Sami Zayn a lot on the NXT thing? Because he kept swearing in the match.
Yeah, he was dropping the F-bombs. What's up with that?
I don't know why he was, but he thought, I guess, the cameras wouldn't hear it or...
Maybe
whatever,
he was saying tabernak. It's not the same thing. It's not the same thing, is it? Tabernak!
Shout out to all the Hebrews and Shebrews.
That's French, dude. It's not Jewish.
I thought he was Jewish. No way, he's Muslim, isn't he?
Who? Zayn?
I don't know if Zayn is he Arabic or...
He's got to be Irish. He's a ginger.
Yeah, I was going to say, not too many ginger Arabs.
What do you mean, Arab? Sami Zayn, Arab.
I thought in his on his tights. On the tights.
Oh,
it has, right.
He's got everything on his tights.
Yeah, I wonder if his name could be like Richard Finkelstein or something.
He's got, he's got every country on his tights. He unified the world.
Whatever Sami Zayn with his headstone type theme song.
I gotta say, that was really funny at the NXT R Evolution pay per view. You know that the music they played before a big match, you know how it goes, dum 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 dum, and they build the tension, dum 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 dum, and Zayn's walking in the back, dum 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 dum. He's looking at the ground and he's like, he's getting ready and he's nervous. It's his last chance. He's gonna have to retire if he loses. Dum 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 dum. And then you hear dum dum dum. Oh, oh, oh. It totally didn't go. His theme song hits.
Well, look at this. Rami Sabre is a Canadian professional wrestler of Syrian descent.
What's his name?
What do you know? Rami Sabre.
Holy smokes. So he is.
Yeah, he's Syrian.
Well, disco's never wrong.
What the hell?
He's ISIS.
Oh!
Oh!
Boom.
It's only too soon if you're Australian.
Jeez. So, thanks for listening, and until next week. What's our sign-off? We're coming up with this on the fly, folks. Bear with us. We need a sign-off.
I'm sure we'll have a racist New Day promo coming up.
Type in the Disco Godzilla sound.
How about, this podcast is dedicated to the memory of Chico Santana.
Oh, jeez. Too soon. Like, literally, because he's not dead.
His gimmick's dead, though.
I don't know. What could we do? What you gonna do when armchair bookers run wild on you? I don't know.
Fuck you, Art.
What? That's a good one.
Armchair Booker T's.
That's really good.
Let's do some armchair booking while Michael Cole is plugging the app for the 100th time. what do you do at the Rumble, guys?
What do you do, or what are they going to do?
What are you? What would you do? Who cares what they're going to? Rumble? Who cares what they're going to do?
You say Roman Reigns is going to be number 30 on the Rumble?
Oh, we already covered it.
And then at the last second, you put in Rey Mysterio to get booed out again.
That's brilliant.
No, I think if they can, you know, talk to Brian, see how he's going to do, and if you can somehow get him to work, you know, 3-4 minutes and be the winner of that Rumble, it'd work out much better for them. And he just doesn't have to work again until Mania.
That's not going to happen. You know that they sent him out the next night. You know that.
You never know. Remember Cena came back at that time in that Rumble? Everyone thought Cena was going to be out for like 5-6 more months and somehow
That was awesome. That's true.
So, I just think you need to end the Shield like a three-way at WrestleMania. For the Shield, they haven't, you know.
Isn't it pronounced Shield?
Shield.
Maybe that's what we should call the show, the Shield.
Spider.
Sierra Hotel Echo India. Or is it the other way around? India Echo. I don't know.
It'll be like WrestleMania 2. They'll fight in those different places.
Maybe the way it works is basically you have Roman win the Rumble. And then you have Dean Ambrose win Elimination Chamber if they still have it. And then you have them have the main event of WrestleMania, and then Seth Rollins goes for the run-in. Huh. With some money in the bank.
Oh, I told you, New Day promo's coming.
Somebody's wearing baby blue.
It's that racist New Day promo.
Baby blue. For those who aren't up to speed on what baby blue in WWE means, it means you're about to get future endeavored. Think about it. Yeah. Think about it. That baby blue. I think these guys are heading for a heel turn, and they're just doing this to honky tonk man them, make them just sugary sweet, disgusting, unlovable baby faces. You're just gonna despise them so much that you're gonna be begging to boo them in a month.
He's ready to explode with like a Martin Luther King esque preach right
now. Have the other like black guys just come during this promo and be like, what the fuck are you guys doing?
I know.
Like Mark Henry and R-Truth just come out like, are you guys fucking insane? And then turns into New Nature Domination.
That's what I do.
I like the positive message, the attempt at like bringing happiness to the world, but this is too much smiling and too much baby blue.
I think with the world events happening as they are, I mean, I don't think you could have gone any other way. Unfortunately.
Really?
Yeah, man.
They should recruit more members. That's what they need. Who do you put in New Day? Who's the newest New Day member?
So Biggie to towel off because he sweat too much.
Probably Cesaro.
Cesaro would be perfect. That would be less Swiss.
He's a real American. He's a black man in New Day. He could be anything, Cesaro.
Do you guys want to hear a really awesome Nikki Bella quote? Or sorry, Brie Bella. Austin Brie Bella quote.
Okay.
Come on, Nikki.
Did you tell that to Cena last night or no?
I wasn't there.
Can somebody tell me why Brie Bella was mic'd so loudly last night? Why did I need to hear everything she had to say?
Because she's smart. Didn't I just show that? She's brilliant.
Those poor buggers in Detroit have to listen to Bella theme for the next 2 minutes.
Brie mode.
Oh, God.
That could be the worst theme in history of wrestling. Brie mode theme.
Well, Light It Up is up there, too.
I still think hearing Light It Up is better than the start of Brie mode.
The synthesized Brie mode. Do you think that's by Mike Tenay?
It could be. Oh yes, that's right.
Forgot about that. Produced by Mike Tenay, but sung by Auto-Tune Brie Bella. Everyone was wondering where that Auto-Tune Anderson promo came from. That was from him.
Auto-Tune.
Remember, like Mr. Anderson.
Oh yeah. I think of Jeff Hardy whenever I think of auto-tune.
Well, inner monologue is when I think of Jeff Hardy.
I haven't been keeping up on TNA in like a year or two, maybe. What is up with Jeff Hardy? Has he dropped that Willow thing?
Yeah.
Yes, he has.
Oh, goody. They've been pushing the Hardys a lot on the network lately. It makes you wonder if they're coming back.
Well, they're tagging again in TNA, where they were the last time I saw them.
It doesn't make any sense to me why they keep airing Jeff Hardy Beyond the Ring specials, Matt Hardy, the Hardy Boys, Hardy Matches. There's a new rivalry coming out of Edge and Christian versus the Hardys. Like, they're not with your organization. Stop pushing the competition. They're not competition, goddammit.
You know what? It's probably they thought maybe, you know, if TNA, they probably thought TNA was going under. And
probably.
Matt has a baby to deal with, so, you know, he'll probably need the extra cash. And Jeff always needs cash, so.
Oh, what are you implying?
I'm implying paint is very expensive.
Oh, paint. Okay. That's okay. That's not libel.
That's why the vigilante always, like, you know.
The vigilante.
He needs to get paid when he for those appearances.
You think they're going to make him drop Sting? Because Vince will be like, there's already a singer named Sting. We're going to call you Vigilante.
They're watching that Beyond the Networks there. I see that what's that stupid guy's name? Mike Adamly must have been watching old Jeff Harvey stuff because they actually called him Jeff Harvey in WWE. They were showing him wrestle when he was like 16, and one of his jobber names was Jeff Harvey, not Jeff Hardy. I thought that was funny.
I think everyone they might have just misspelled it.
Well, I just remember when Adam Lee first came out, he's like, and your opponent is Jeff Harvey.
Who could forget?
That's like, maybe that was the era when he was, during American Gladiators, he was watching Superstars and Jeff Harvey came out.
All right.
What kind of promo for Total Divas is it? They're running to each other in slow motion.
So, the Divas, the Bellas, have made peace. They've worked out their differences. All it took was Brie being a slave to her sister for a month.
Nope, not a month. Technically, it was like 20 days or something ridiculous. 20 days. It was like, you're supposed to be a slave for 20, 30 days, but...
Do you think Daniel Bryan comes back and he's like, what are you doing, Brie? Is there going to be conflict?
I think it's going to be more like, this is a big part of a bigger plan. You know how you trick Bray Wyatt by joining his family?
Yeah.
I'm going to turn on Nikki the moment it suits me.
Oh, there you go.
I'm pretty sure that the promo they had like before the match last night, I thought for sure that was like, you know, like screaming turn.
So you don't think Come On Nikki is genuine?
No, I think it's all an act. The moment they get into like a situation where the belt's up for grabs, you get to see that small package.
What small package?
A Brian small package. What was that?
Oh, you know, distraction, small package, win the belts.
Okay.
That's how it goes. This is an NXT. Where
what does Triple H have match. To do with any of this?
The whole thing about, I wish you died in the womb, it was all an act.
Oh,
back.
Oh, jeez.
Wish you died in the womb!
Womb!
Well, fans, you thought Charlotte Sasha Banks was a classic.
Here you go.
There you go. Here's another one.
Oh, by the way, guys, Charlotte losing on Raw wasn't really a debut. It wasn't. Even though there was a package, even though they made her, gave her a ring entrance, it wasn't a debut.
It didn't count, eh? They've done that before. It's Uh-oh. Stricken from the history books.
Nikki Bella, the same thing that happened, how she... hurt her leg the first time is happening again.
Explain to me how the wrestler with the snuggest looking sharpshooter today is Natalya and not
any other man who does it.
Because The Rock's pathetic attempt at a sharpshooter.
The Rock drops to a knee because he gets tired.
It's,
Well, Tyson's is pretty good, too. I got to give him props.
Oh, she doesn't have balls
and
to deal with.
And they still have a douchebag stable.
That's a good point.
Keep me in on that.
What's that, heel?
They should have a douchebag stable. Tyson's in on that.
Well, you got to have Douchetista as the head of that.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Actually, Douchetista is a douchebag stable all by himself. Give me the spotlight.
His options seem so different. Extreme Rules match, Street Fight, and No Holds Barred.
Where's the
greatest poll ever.
Yeah, they just threw up a graphic of Chris Jericho versus, is it versus Paul Heyman?
Yeah.
Okay, and the options are basically all hardcore matches. Where's the coal miner's glove match?
I think the winner gets the payout.
$200 on a pole.
That'd be awesome. Bounce check on a pole match.
Royalty check on a pole.
VHS tape on a pole match. They don't do those anymore. Thank God.
They had an Ambrose pole match with Cena, didn't they, that like a couple months ago?
Right. They had some sort of a document, a contract on a pole match.
Terrible.
Yeah.
Oh, that was the who gets to fight Seth Rollins first match.
Which ended up being irrelevant, as is everything in wrestling today.
Yep.
Eventually, everything is irrelevant. Is that... I
was going to say, Ambrose won that match, yet the number one contender thing was Cena versus Orton. So why did Ambrose have to win that match to face Rollins? That's terrible.
I don't know. I'm hoping that Seth injects himself... Is that the right word? Injects? Interjects? Himself into that Brock Cena match just to make it a little fresher. I don't want to see Brock Cena again. So three-way dance with Seth so he can bounce around like a pinball.
Does Seth cash that thing in? Does he cash in the Rumble?
I think he should. I think he should be stand up. He should go out there and go, I'm cashing in. Since he sounds like Ross from Monsters, Inc. I'm going to cash my chips in.
Has he brought up that he hasn't had a chance to cash it in for 4 months?
No.
This guy should get an extra four months on his ability to cash in because he hasn't had a chance to cash in.
Well,
that's
I think
a good
we were
point.
Saying last week they should have vignettes where he goes to Brock's retreat in Winnipeg.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Brock almost shoots him with a deer hunting rifle.
Rock salt. He shoots him with rock salt. Get off my property. Brock's kids are shooting him with rock salt, too.
Oh, my God.
That'd be awesome, man. Seth curb stomps one of Brock's cows.
Curb stomps Sable.
Brock comes out all pissed off the next week on Raw. Ka-ka! Ka-ka!
Sable opens the door and she just has Brock Lesnar's hands painted on her tits. Like, time back in the day. So cool.
That's
hands.
A dysfunctional family. Yeah, Brock comes out after having his cow curb stomped. He comes out, he's huffing, he's puffing, he's mad, he's bouncing off the ropes, he's snarling, he takes the mic and he goes, Paul, say something stupid! It's meme night here on Armchair Bookers.
Meme Gene?
Meme Gene. All right, we're back to Raw.
Oh, we're back to SmackDown Pro. Oh, returns to action. Against the bunny.
That's a nice graphic. That makes Roman look strong.
Doesn't that look like Triple H's logo in the middle there? The nail and the Hardy Boys look?
Yeah, or Warrior.
The Warriors,
just,
yeah.
They just, the nail is Taker. They just took everyone's logo and tried to make Roman look strong.
That scarf looked longer.
what's the deal with no light up coat? He always on his podcast, he's talking about, I have to wear the coat everywhere now. If I don't wear the coat, people lose their minds. And he comes out without the light up coat.
I guess it was warm in Detroit today. Didn't need the coat. Or it was raining. He didn't want to get electrocuted like Ambrose did last night.
He's all over the show.
What do you guys think about Jericho constantly coming back and leaving and coming back and leaving? Like, literally, is this like his fourth comeback this year?
His second comeback, but I think he talked about it before. Like, he's not less interested in like being on TV and more doing the house show circuit.
He wants to do house shows. Jeez.
I don't want to be on TV. I just want to do interesting matches on house shows that nobody will see.
I want to get hit with giant bags of popcorn. Slammed on bags of popcorn.
I guess in a way it's more creatively in tune with what he feels now. Like, in TV, he has to be scripted and such. And like on the road, you don't really have to be. It's pretty much like them calling it.
He wants it to be fun.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, like, I think it's worked out for the best for Jericho, because at the end of the day, he's won every belt. He's won everything you can in this company. You don't need him to be around all the time.
And he can lose all the time, too.
You can lose him, still be a legend, leave, come back strong.
Yeah, get beat by 100 guys, beat Bray Wyatt, leave.
Yeah.
I'll give a,
so they're using Jericho to get Rusev and probably Brock Lesnar over.
Give the rub to Fandango, who never used the rub except when she's rubbing his body.
Fan fuck farts.
Man, that freaking dress is tight on that girl.
I'm guessing she's, we're in the middle, folks, of a Lana Rusev promo. They're on, what is his show called? The Highlight Reel? Do you think Lana goes through the obnoxiously, ridiculously, obscenely expensive Geritron 5000? Well, watch out. That thing might explode.
just keep Ambrose away from
it. Look,
hey, Rusev.
There's only one long-haired blonde that I can accept with a lazy eye and, you know.
She has a lazy eye?
No, I'm just saying, like, I accept Shawn Michaels.
It gives you a lazy eye, right.
Rusev's gonna super kick her and throw her through the TV.
No, she was trying to escape through the Geritron. Let's get that straight.
I'm trying to say that Shawn Michaels has Saturnitis in his eyes.
Yeah, he had that a little before that happened, but it was good timing. They used it to cover it up. True story on Michaels' cross eye is from a Kane chokeslam. What just happened? Did something?
He said the Rusev should show Lana his Sputnik.
Jericho is insinuating there's a romantic relationship between Lana and Rusev. And now he's singing that they're. Yeah.
He's going for Cena right now. He's like, I can have Cena, you, John.
See, once in a while, Jericho doing this, it's okay. Him doing this every night, I don't think so. We don't do that at all. Have you seen your Instagram? Like, geez, how many soccer games do you go to watch?
You know, Rusev should grab the mic and go, there's nothing going on between us. I'm gay.
I mean, Machka.
Machka. Udrev. Rusev, Machka. Rusev, gay.
Rusev, talk.
Oh, yeah. There's nothing to do with this thing, but I figured out who the bunny is going to be. Adrian Neville.
No.
He's going to come up to the roster as the buddy.
Screech.
The whole time.
Did you come out to that, Saved by the Bell, the new college year song?
Yeah, it's all right. Because I'm saved by the bell.
No, I mean the other one, the college year song. The beginning of the end of tomorrow.
Guys, there's some shit going. Yeah. There's some serious shit going down in the ring here. This is like, this is shades of Andre Hogan on Piper's Pit. We've got some tension between Rusev and Jericho here.
Jericho's gonna rip.
Drago and Apollo.
Drago and Apollo. Don't stop the match, baby.
If he dies, he dies.
I must break.
Watch out, man. Jericho's gonna rip the star off and leave him bleeding.
Oh my God. That'd be great.
Oh, looks like they're feeding Ryback to Rusev.
Feed me gruel.
Also, when we were talking about booking the Rumble, I just hope they don't use any of these bigger name guys in just regular matches and not the Rumble.
That does.
Then it'll be too predictable that Roman Reigns wins.
Wasn't there a rumor like they wanted to expand the Rumble again to 40?
They canceled that, I think. Yeah. I think it was at the last show they did in Philly. It said, "Come back for the Rumble. It'll be a 40-man Rumble or some thing like that."
He's about to steroid all over his face.
They had to cancel the 40-man Rumble because the only guy who could win a 40-man Rumble isn't around anymore.
Excuse me, Roman Reigns
is still around.
He can run. No, I was
talking about Alberto El Patron.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Batista.
Coming to a ring of honor.
Right.
Yeah, I'm hoping that Rumble just is like, the last few years it's only been like three matches and the Rumble match.
Yeah.
So you got the Brock and Cena match. I just hope you just have like a terrible 5-minute women's match and maybe some sort of tag team title match and leave all these guys to actually be in the Rumble. You want to do feuds? Let them feud in the Rumble match itself like it used to be back
in
the day.
I always love that when guys would run in halfway through a Rumble and it's like, oh, you motherfucker. And the feud would like...
Chico would come out when Model's in there. Oh my God.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. The Martel Santana feud for 7 years. You motherfucker! Arriba!
Every time he went to the ring, he'd just run right at Martel. Every
year.
After Martel's been in there for like 40 minutes after like every Rumble.
Yeah.
Or somehow Rick Martel always lasted forever.
And then you got Gorilla going, no love lost between these two youngsters.
They won the tag titles 8 years ago. Oh. It's a happening in this Rumble.
It's a happening. I speak a little Russian. I'll translate for you. Rusev just said, I must leave. You are a very scary big American, and I don't want to get hurt.
Lana, say something stupid.
Say something stupid, Lana.
They're going to show the promos with, like, Ryback running on a treadmill, getting steroids put in by someone.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God, man.
Did they do that in Rocky IV?
It's the American steroids this time.
Yeah, when Drago's training.
It's basically
them injecting steroids.
There was no subtlety in that montage. It's basically we're just injecting it straight into your muscle.
Yeah,
I remember the injections. I never thought they were steroids. I thought they were like Nuke from RoboCop 2 or something.
Nuke.
Then they had him run on a treadmill that was friggin' like 30-degree angle or something.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And what was Rocky's equivalent? Oh, I'm just running up a mountain.
Through snow, I have a log on my back.
He almost killed Drago making avalanches, yelling Drago up in the...
I carry a log too. Except I have to run up a hill.
You think there's a promo airing right now, a recap of TLC of Roman Reigns putting show through a table. Do you think the editor got some tips on how to put this package together? Do you think they told the editor, make Reigns look really, really strong? I wonder if everyone's like, God damn it, okay. I get it.
Uh-oh, they're playing that Adrian Neville, like, Sami Zayn song.
They're playing the Sami Zayn pre-match song.
That's the Adam Rose's theme right after.
Look at this. After a gimmick-heavy match.
Oh, that's crazy, man.
Another cage match.
Cena versus Rollins tonight in a cage because
they can.
Oh my God! Because it's 24 hours later, they should be fine.
They only eat through like three tables. It's all good.
Is that like mid Raw main event, or is that like at the end of the mid Raw main event?
I hope so, mid-raw, because I don't ever make it through these things all the way through.
I don't think it'll be mid-raw. I think the mid-raw will be Jericho and Heyman with Brock.
Good night, Heel.
Brock's good.
All right. We're going to all take a moment here and say good night, Big Heel, Danny Blanchard, Scott McCullough. It was nice talking to you tonight.
You and I check out.
he's like Taker. He just blink and he's gone. Trapdoor. Trapdoor.
Trapdoor. He's like the vigilante. In, out.
I'm still trying to work out. I'm like ROH. I don't have the technology to do a hologram yet. So I can't make a hologram.
Damn it, Heel. Stop pointing the camera at the lights.
Let's flare.
Saw you running away with your rocking chair in the dark. Bray Wyatt styles.
Boo.
How long should we do this for? Should we just make it an hour every time? You think people can take more than an hour of this stuff? I don't know. I'm always saying wrestling should be an hour. I love NXT because it's an hour. I loved old ECW because it was an hour, and Superstars and the old original Raws. 3 hours is excruciating. ROH needs better production value. JR is totally right about that. And they need to invest in some lights.
Hour long is probably good enough. I mean, like, hell. I mean, most people don't stay on, unless you're Chris CM Punk. You don't deserve more than an hour and a half.
Sorry, go ahead.
Has Punk quit UFC yet? Just a quick question.
Not yet.
Okay.
I was going to say, has Ambrose main evented more pay-per-views than Punk did during his whole reign?
Yes, he did.
Yes, he has.
Yes. Doesn't even have the belt. Punk had it had the belt a whole year. God damn it, you're going on second last.
Yeah, we got to put, what was it like, didn't they one time they had like, didn't they have like Cena Kane after him or something, or Cena Big Show? Yep. Something terrible.
Yeah, that was just stewing and bubbling for a long time.
The difference. Ambrose, Bray Wyatt, they're not millennials, they're not Swiss.
We're going to make you the longest reigning, most inconsequential title reign in the past decade. Thanks, I think.
You got a job to Undertaker.
Even Rey Mysterio
to better.
Punk is a little crazy if he thinks he should have gone over both Rock and Taker. That does show you a little.
Both. I don't think he should have gone out. I don't think that was his point. I think his point was basically with Taker, he should have been the main event, not Rock and Cena.
Look here it is. We got an Ascension promo. Well,
wait,
what a rush!
They're wearing shoulder pads now. And they have a little bit of paint on.
You tell them, Victor.
Look at their foreheads. Their foreheads are painted. They've got eyeliner on one of their eyes. Tell them, Victor. Well.
I'll take another tag team. I can't really complain about having.
We're the Weasel Slappers. You're the Weasels.
Every week should be them promoting themselves as an old tag team. LOB 1 week. No, Killer Bees the next week.
Bees would be awesome because they just have nothing
Bulldogs
to say.
With the accents the week after. Just keep doing that.
How long before Heidenreich joins the group or when they roll out draws?
Oh, jeez. Jeez. who else is there? And even like obscure teams, like they come out as someone that no one would know, like TNT, yep. Morocco, and Orton. Cowboy Bob Orton and Don Morocco.
Pan Am Connection.
What?
The New Dream Team, Dino Prophet.
The New Dream Team.
Valentine.
Rhythm and Blues. New
Air
Rhythm.
Boom.
Or even rip off a current team. New Day. What?
New Jannetty and 1-2-3 Kid.
We got the baby blue guys in the ring. If you go back throughout history,
And I didn't come up with this theory. It's Honky Tonk Man's theory. And he lived it. When Vince, back in the day, wanted to get rid of somebody, when it was time to finish up, he put him in baby blue. He'd say, "You know, pal, I think you'd look good in baby blue." And they put Don Morocco, who wore black and dark, dark blue for years and years and years, they put him in baby blue, gone by the end of the year. Hercules, gone. Actually, he may have stuck around in that tag team, Power and Glory. Anyway, it was the beginning of the end. Honky got put in the baby blue. Bunch of other people. In an unrelated note, Disco, I've got a new baby blue leisure suit for you. Has nothing to do with what I was just talking about.
You got it back from Chico.
Hey, talking about Demolition, what's he wearing? He looks like Axe. He's got silver paint.
Yeah, he's not the Great Kazoo.
He doesn't look like Zartan. He's morphing into Axe from Demolition.
Maybe Xavier Woods is wrestling today. Looks like he won the choose.
Coin flip.
Oh, he did. He did win the choose.
It's Creed. It's Consequences Creed.
We just had the Apollo Creed promo the last one.
Yep.
Now we got Consequences Creed.
Oh, yeah. I don't think I've seen him wrestle since he started this new day gimmick. He might have on SmackDown for all I know, but...
So many Rocky IV references so far in this show.
You never have too many.
Are you saying Xavier Woods is going to die?
He could.
You can base a whole promotion off of Rocky IV. I'm wondering when Goldust...
on fire. What do you want from
him? I'm wondering when Goldust's Fountain of Youth is going to run out. Because the guy's moving like a guy half his age. He's moving faster than he ever has, literally. Like, he's working better than he was as the natural Dustin Rhodes.
I think he weighs less now than he did in 1990.
Yeah.
He's wrestling more leaner and meaner. Yep.
Quicker.
It'll be 25 years since his first Rumble appearance.
Jeez.
1990 Rumble, him and Dusty versus Virgil and and Million Dollar Man.
Man, it was only just yesterday when I just saw Goldust feel up Razor Ramon.
20 years ago yesterday.
Memories.
That was crazy.
He did an interview, Goldust did a while ago, and someone had one of his old outfits that they got on eBay, I think it was. And they were asking Dustin, is this legit? Is this like one of the ones you wore? And he was like, "Let me see the crotch piece. Yep, that's one of mine."
Him and Iron Sheik always seem to like have an extra bulge come.
No, I guess they wear out. The crotch wears out the quickest on them, and he's like, "Yep, I remember that one."
Yeah, and Iron Sheik was wearing baby blue when he lost the title to Hogan.
Oh, right.
So, there you go. More of that. You're losing the title tonight. You're wearing baby blue.
Baby blue.
Don't worry, Sheiky baby.
Yeah, listeners, if you can remember any instances of the baby blue curse, definitely let us know. It's a fun little factoid. Now, you know, if Stardust comes out wearing baby blue,
oh,
we wish Cody Rhodes the best at his future endeavors.
I think he got fired. It just showed you the terrible gimmick. Baby blue Farouk.
Baby blue Farouk.
That's well. That's right. He used to come with the helmet and everything.
Oh right, that's right. The Gladiator.
It was managed by Sonny.
Managed by Sonny. Why? Made no sense. Just like Legion of Doom, managed by Sonny. Why?
She managed everyone and she managed like four tag team champions in like a year span.
They were
managed the Bananas. The Godwins, the Smoking Guns, the LOD.
Oh, yeah. They were trying to make her the new Lou Albano.
They were.
The manager of champions.
With his blue ring on his face.
We've got a barn
burner. So I'm going to New York in mid-March, and I'm looking up hotels. And here's a hotel that popped up that's really price-effective. But I don't know.
What are you going to New York for?
Stay there or not.
What are you going to New York for, Heel?
I'm going to, they're doing a live podcast recording of this Survivor podcast I listen to.
Oh, sweet.
I'm going to go check that out.
You going to see any wrestling down there?
I don't think so. It's like a Wednesday night, so I don't know.
That's McMahon's territory.
That's Ring of Honor is...
Be careful, that's McMahon's territory. Don't run in his backyard.
Who are they inviting in the podcast?
Rob Cesternino from Survivor Amazon, and Stephen Fishback from Survivor Token Chains do it. But then, like, all these people who live in New York are going to go to it. So, like, Parvati and a whole bunch of other people.
Wouldn't it be a heel move to bring in Boston Rob?
Boston, it would be a heel move to bring in Boston Rob.
Hello, New York!
In, though, like Jericho on the bus.
Are you going for what? For the finale on Wednesday, or...?
No, it's just like, it's in March, so it's like season 30, but it's like episode 4 or something.
Oh, okay, no, I thought maybe you were going for this Wednesday.
No, I wish. I've tried to get tickets to the finales for the past 3 years, and just can't.
All right, we're a little over an hour now. I think it's time to wrap the recording up. So, because there's nothing going on Raw. Not now, not ever.
Not even college.
I don't know. Closing thoughts for this week. Are you satisfied with the show you've seen?
We're talking about the Survivor podcast right now, so no.
That's how exciting it is right now.
Right. Well, hopefully we provided listeners with a little more enjoyment than Vince and company did. So for Jack, Disco, Pisco, for the big heel, Danny Blanchard, a.k.a. Scott McCulloch, and for Magnum G.R., we've got his brakes fixed this week.
I did.
Way to go, George Rappos.
I made it home in time for this amazing hour of sports entertainment.
Sports entertainment. Are you not sports entertained? I am Dirk, the work Burton, a.k.a. Michael Mercy. And we all like to thank you for listening. And if you like it, if you like what you heard, let us know. Share it. Post it around. There's like 1,000 Facebook wrestling pages. So I'll throw it on there. Put it on your Facebook page. Tweet it. Definitely tweet it. And do you guys have Twitter?
I don't know.
Do you want to throw Twitters out? I don't know if there's even any point to it. I'm at Michael Mercy. Follow me. I really don't give a shit. I don't tweet. I don't read tweets.
You sound like Stone Cold asking Vince. You sound like Stone Cold asking Vince about how did King A reach you? How can audience reach you?
Shaking your head.
Steve is out of his mind. What's your personal number, son? What's your personal cell phone so they can talk to you? Vince is like, Steve, you're out of your goddamn mind if you think I'm going to share that information. Just yell at Titan Towers. Come down to Connecticut and throw a piece of paper that you've written on. Heel, do you want to share your Twitter?
Yep.
Do we want to? Do we want people knowing who we are?
Yeah, I'm at ButtsMcSee on Twitter. ButzMcC.
And Disco, what's yours? It's like 4WABCD 123.
It's at Jack TWD 4TH.
What does that stand for?
Really? Actually, it was the three-way Dan's fourth member.
Oh shit!
I didn't even know that.
That's awesome. No,
I think most people thought it was The Walking Dead fourth. I don't know why. That's I never talk about awesome. The Walking Dead.
This this show, I use in air quotes, if you can call it that, used to be called Three Way Dance. We tried to do it once or twice before, and it was three-way dance with three people, but we always seemed to have four or five people on it, which was cool. You know, when we'd get together, it'd be three-way dance with five or six guys holding up four fingers, the classic horseman thing. But I did not know that. That's amazing. Are you gonna are you gonna make a new one now, Jack Armchair Booker?
We'll see. I need to protect my brand. So
right, you're stuck with it like CM Punk.
Yeah, I guess.
So if you go to UFC, are you planning on fighting in UFC? And if you are you going to use that Twitter handle?
I probably will, but then I'll probably quit halfway through training.
Because it's hard.
It is hard.
It hurts. Magnum G.R., do you have a Twitter?
I got ICQ number 5367-2424.
What the fuck is ICQ?
It's an old instant messaging program from the late 90s, early 2000s.
Oh my god, I think I remember that from high school. Is that like through your dial-up modem bulletin board? BBS?
Go to icqtogo.com. I believe this program still exists.
Okay.
At least 10 years after it's dead.
All right. Look for it. Use the search engine Ask Jeeves.
Dogpile and Ask Jeeves.
Alta Vista.
All right. Well, thanks everyone for listening, and we'll probably be back next week if we feel like it. So until then, what you going to do when Armchair Bookers run wild on you?
Yeah.
Dig it? Oh, yeah. Okay, we'll work on our sign off. Peace, everybody.